Thanks, guys. I'm here backstage at Toni Storm. And Toni, the last several weeks here on SmackDown have been very eventful, emotional, and tonight was no exception when it comes to Charlotte Flair. After she was disqualified in the match, she then took it upon herself to attack you. Do you feel like she's taking advantage of the fact that you're newer around here?
I may be new, but I'm not just some scared little girl. And she knows that. And that's why she snapped and did what she did. But you know what? It doesn't matter what she does to me. I'm in her head, and she knows that I'm gonna take her SmackDown Women's Championship. And she knows that if there's a sad little girl around here, it's her.
Well, you're clearly very shaken up, understandably so. That match was not that long ago tonight, but you did get some positive words from Sasha Banks. And Sasha is someone who has dealt with Charlotte Flair for many years. So what did that do for you confidence-wise to get those words from Sasha?
You know, I've been a fan of Sasha Banks for so long, and it means the world that the boss has my back. And you know what? I'm not just going to take this title to make myself proud. I'm gonna do this to make the whole locker room proud, to make the whole WWE universe proud.
Well, I think I can speak for a lot of people. We're behind you, Toni, and keep your head up. And good luck as you continue challenging the queen. So thank you, and we're gonna send things back to you guys. Hey guys, backstage with Drew McIntyre, who had a very victorious night over Sheamus, who, by the way, was the guy who kind of was like making fun of you after your name wasn't on the list for the Black Friday Invitational Battle Royal.
Yeah,
and
you kind of. It's so easy to say. I've said it so many times the past few weeks.
But was that sad?
Black Friday Invitational Battle Royal.
But was it satisfying to kind of get that victory over Sheamus tonight?
Yes, it's always satisfying to get victory over Sheamus. You know, I can't remember how long ago it was now that he, you know, turned his back on me after 20 years and kicked me in the face. And I figured we'd have got through it by now, mm-hmm. but still, he's been an ass. Still, he's laughing in my face and mm-hmm. still kicking his head off his body. So it's always a good day for me and for the WWE Universe. They get to see two big guys beating the hell out of each other.
Well, I feel it's been a good day for you every Friday night SmackDown. No one's really been able to take you down. So, I mean, obviously, you're doing what you said you were going to do when you first did arrive here on the Blue Brand.
Yeah. It's as simple as that, yeah. I'm having some great matches, some great opponents, but I came to SmackDown to reinvent myself. As I said, start from the bottom, work my way to the top, do whatever I have to do, just like I did on Raw to make it to the top. I'm getting some high-quality opponents, I'm getting hard-hitting matches, and in the end, Big D is getting the big W.
Is there anybody in particular that you haven't faced yet, or that you have faced yet, that you've particularly enjoyed squaring up in the ring with, or that you want to square up in the ring with? Sorry, I know it's always a question you ask to put you on the spot. Can you list the entire roster? Go!
Sir, there aren't a lot of people, but somebody that I've never faced, we've both been wrestling now for 20-plus years, is Cesaro. Mm. It's unbelievable. We've never had a singles match. He's a phenomenal competitor. It's going to happen. It's going to be awesome. And sorry, buddy, I am going to kick your head off, too.
Are you buying, you know, the holidays are around the corner, or have you been buying Christmas presents for all of your fellow WWE superstars?
Tons. I just got one myself. You seen my new Bobby the Brain Heenan shirt? Yeah. What a guy. Stick with me, you go to the top. You don't stick with me, you're never heard from again. Mm. What a guy.
Well, Drew, thank you so much, and I look forward to seeing you continue to kick people's arses every
so
week.
Many arses. So many arses to be kicked, and they're going to get kicked. Thank you, Kayla.
Thank you, Drew. All right, back to you guys.
Yeah, that's right, Jackie and Matt. I'm standing backstage with the New Day.
You gotta say it right. Yeah. You have to say the
New Day. Sorry. Take a breath, pause. New Day.
Try it again.
Enthusiasm. Get your enthusiasm.
New Day.
Hey!
The article is very important.
The New Day.
There you go.
Who just won a triple threat match for the best tag team. How are you guys feeling after defeating RK-Bro and the Usos?
I mean, we feel like I told you so. We've been telling everybody that we're the best tag team for a very long time. As a matter of fact, on WWE.com several months ago, we won the award for the greatest tag team of all time. So it was kind of a spoiler alert by putting us in that match.
What do you mean?
We knew we were going to be the best.
We don't understand why we're having this match, because we were already deemed the greatest by our record one, then by the company that writes our checks too, and then to be put in a match to say who's the best. Like,
you already knew. And it's cool, you know, everybody's wanting to get the title. You know, you want to have the Raw Tag Team Championship, the SmackDown Tag Team Championship. Just because we don't have the actual physical belts around our waist does not mean that we are not the champions, man.
All that means is that we're allowing other people to breathe for a second. We've had a stranglehold, a literal stranglehold on this division for damn near a decade at this point. So we're allowing other teams to flourish a little bit, and we say, you know what, you're on the boat now. We'll take a little hiatus. We'll go get a crown.
That's right.
We'll go become king. We'll go make sure we got a hand. We'll make sure that he's heavyweight champion. And then when we feel like it, we'll take the titles. Hell, we might take the Raw titles too. Who knows? We might go to NXT, take those. And then we might talk to Pretty Deadly and take the NXT UK titles. Who knows?
Bro, we got real long torsos. There's a lot of titles that can fit around our torsos and our waist. There's a lot of room for it. It's just a matter of pulling the, you know, doing it when we want to do it. You know what I'm saying? Yo, Zay, that's the king right there, by the way.
Hello.
Look at, can you talk about his new crown? Can you marvel at his new crown?
Talk about it.
New crown is
fantastic.
The pink jewels on the crown,
the adornments.
And the color.
The accoutrement.
But I do have to ask you guys, you defeated the Usos tonight, who are the SmackDown Tag Team Champions.
Right. Yeah.
Are you next?
People ask these questions when you beat the champions. Are you next in line? I beat Bobby Lashley when he was heavyweight champion. Did I get a shot? I technically beat Roman while he's Universal Champion. Did I ever get a shot? We've beaten the Usos countless times where they've been champions. And yes, before we got shots. Are we going to get a shot now? Probably. Are we going to become champions again? Probably. Are we going to have to go to Raw as well and win those championships too? Probably. All of these things already have answers. New Day's the greatest. Everybody here is fantastic. They work hard. They're fantastic workers in the ring. But we are just better. We're on a different level. We're the Simone Biles of professional wrestling. You know, she competes on a different level than literally everyone else. They have to score her so much more difficultly. That's a word. That's what we are.
You see that? You see, he's a benevolent king. He is a smart king. He'll just bless you with new vocabulary. He'll tell you what's going on in the kingdom. He'll tell you what's going to happen. That's a spoiler alert. That's why he is the king. They're trying to give us the wrap it up sign. They don't want to hear. You don't cut the king off when the king is speaking, sir. Sir, we don't try to wrap the king up. When the king is finished speaking and proclaiming, then and only then will we wrap it up. Then and only then will we take it home, as they say in the biz. No, we ain't ready yet. When the king is ready, then we will cut it off. Then and only then.
Matter of fact, this interview, talk to the hand, because the king don't want to hear it.
Hi, Meg.
All right, back to you guys in the studio.
You're supposed to talk to the hand. Fire.